Hello everyone, welcome back to Steam Code. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to create a click handler using only CSS. Now, you may already know, but CSS is only a style sheet language. It's not a programming language like JavaScript or Java or PHP. It's only a style sheet language. And so, creating a click event or simulating a click event using CSS might be complicated, but it will allow you to do some things that you may have not known you're able to do using this language. So let's jump right into this. So I have two files here, index.html and main.css in the same directory. And we're just gonna create some basic code here for the HTML file. So for the head, we're just gonna set the title to CSS click handler. And we're going to link to our main.css file. So rel equals stylesheet. And href will equal main.css. Okay. Now within our body, we're going to be doing something called the checkbox hack. So what this checkbox hack allows you to do is, using a checkbox and its label, you're able to simulate when a user has clicked on a button or really anything you want. So let's create an input here. Input type equals checkbox. And we're gonna set the ID to check one. And the name will equal check one as well. They're going to create a label for it. So label, this is just going to be for check one. My bad, I keep on adding this plus. So let's save this and see how it looks. As you can see, we have our title here, and then we also have our checkbox. We haven't put anything inside of our label yet. Let's just say click me. All right. As you can see, once we click on the label or the checkbox, it's now activated. And when you click again, it becomes deactivated. Perfect. So now let's create the object that we actually want to change once we click on the checkbox. So we can create a div. We'll just call the class box. And as you can see, you can't see the div just yet because we haven't added any style to it. So now, let's hop right into the CSS. This is really all we need for the HTML. Everything we're going to be doing for the most part is within the CSS file. So let's say, well, first let's style the div. So let's say body. I'll set the height to 450 pixels. Same with the width. And the border will be 2 pixels. Solid black, and we'll set the background color to, let's say, orange. Okay. Oh, that's body. This is supposed to be box. All right, there we go. Now we have our div up here. This is 450 by 450 pixels. It's fully orange background. So now let's change it once the user clicks on the checkbox. So we can say input, let's specify the type, type equals checkbox. And you can specify the ID or the name depending on how many you have and how specific you want to be. Then we can use this tilde operator, and this tilde symbol within CSS just means it's just the general symboling combinator. And so I'll just show you how it works. And then right here, let's say checked. So how does this entire thing work? So what this is saying is, for all the inputs that have a type of checkbox, we only have one, which is this, then once it's checked, then do onto the div whatever we have within these two curly brackets. And we can change anything we want about that div. So let's set the background color to aqua. And let's just set the height and width to something else. So height we can set to 400 pixels. And let's set the width to 200 pixels. So let's save this. If we click on this, as you can see, now the box changes. Then we can unclick, click again, unclick. You can do this as many times as you want, and now you've simulated a click event. And so say you want these things, say you don't want to see the checkbox or the label, you can actually get rid of it and overlay the two elements. So let's get rid of the label. Save this. So now we only have the checkbox and the div. And let's change the dimensions of that checkbox. So check one. We'll set the height to 200 pixels. And we'll also set the width to 200 pixels. Or, my bad, 450. Let's set that to 450 as well. Okay, now let's set the position to absolute so they overlay each other. So position, absolute. And same thing for the box, position absolute. What this does is it just allows them to overlay over each other. But as you can see right here, it still works even though the checkbox is bigger. The div still changes, now let's reload. And as you can see, now they're overlaying each other. But as you can see, as I'm clicking on this div, nothing's happening. And the reason why is because the checkbox is laying underneath the div, meaning it's fully concealed and no pointer events are able to access it. Well, the way we fix this is just by adding this attribute right here for the box, pointer events, and we can set that to none. Now what this does is it makes all of the pointer events, such as hover, clicking, or whatever other pointer events there are, and it takes them all away for that div and allows anything under that div to be affected by those pointer events. So now if we click on this, as we can see, it still changes. Let's keep the height and width the same so that we're not seeing the checkbox. And as you can see, now as we click on this, it changes. Now as you can see, there are a bunch of different applications for this. If you're creating a project in which you only want to use CSS and HTML and no JavaScript, or if you're just having some fun and trying to learn different facets of this language. But I hope this video has taught you something. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe. Please check out our Patreon and our GitHub as well. This has been Steamcode. I'll see you next time.